Gut. It will not look as slick as the other drill machine. The problem is that we have to put more machines on here. So we will have to put an oxygen producer on here and yeah, some tanks. Because if we want to directly produce oxygen with this machine, then we have to put some tanks on here. A normal drill would have worked too, so we could just drill out the ice and bring it back. But I want to go for a ship that produces oxygen. I don't know if you This ship will have storage for normal ores too, because it in the wake of drilling into ice, it will also get everything else. So we need more storage too. But and that's a thing I didn't test. I can just assume if we store the oxygen, we can get rid of the kind of we can. I hope that this thing can store more oxygen than ice, so that we don't have to use up all the internal storage for ice. We can use that for. Oh sh. We can use that for other ores. Let me get rid of some of the materials we have in our inventory. So it's I assume. Oh, that was okay. Let me. I hope the width is enough that I'm having enough space behind that. I want to be a bit bigger than the thrusters on top here. So you can see that the thrusters are behind the shielding here, and the area the drills dig out is a bit bigger than this block, so that we can kind of drive the drills straight into an asteroid. Come on, let's finish this. I will have to back up the ship a bit because I need to attach the drills now. This will take more work. I think this is the Wednesday episode. We will do more. This is just preparation to prepare this for our main mission here. Okay, this and this, we need to reload our batteries now. Drills are basically the whole building drilling machines. At one point, don't know. There would never will be a perfect drilling machine in my opinion. At least not with the vanilla stuff. What I saw, I'm watching other YouTubers too that build machines in Space Engineers, and there's some really really cool stuff. People that build mining machines that kind of you just have to fly to an asteroid and then you just set them up and they eat the whole asteroid on their own. Oh, no. I should look more for the volume I'm storing here. What is it's the metal grids. The metal grids take up a lot of space. A lot of space. Hate them. So, and this stuff is amazingly cool. I can only dream of something like that. I saw one guy made a drilling machine that works in conjunction with sensors and with sensors and with the C, the programmable blocks. You can do so much cool stuff with it, but you all know that I'm not no fan is the fan is the wrong word. I can't use that again. The programmable blocks are way off my how I understand the world, kind of. I would have to learn programming, and I'm not a programmer. The sensors I will have to test again. I made these tests with my automatic drilling machine that I can set up and then just let it run, and it does stuff on its own. But the sensors there didn't what I wanted them to do. I'm still a bit angry about that, because I thought that I have set that up set up everything right. It was a machine that I tested with an automatic clamping system, so that it kind of goes to an asteroid. You can put out your landing legs, kind of clamps, so that they can come down, and when the senses the asteroid, it kind of activates landing gears that hold the clamps on the asteroid. And so the problem with that was that the sensors, the time the sensors worked out, the timing was not good. So I couldn't time it that it held on all the... Sometimes it works, because, I don't know, there was flat area on the asteroid where it could grab the material, but and on other points the sensor sensed the asteroid and then activated the landing gears, but the landing gears didn't hold to the asteroid, or sometimes the sensor didn't sense the asteroid and the landing gears were already smashed into it, and it was not nice. Okay, let's back up that ship a bit. And I want to take a look at that again, because sensors could be a thing that I could wrap my head around, and so I could at least do some stuff with the sensors without going too crazy. But if they work the way they did for me at that point, then I don't know if I want to invest the time into learning that, because I'm doing, yeah, don't know, a weekly show here, and I'm, what I don't want to do is, yeah, spend a lot of time into that, or bring a lot of time into that, and then don't get it to work on camera, basically. I'm trying to not play Space Engineers a lot, because I don't want to burn myself out on it. And if, yeah, I would do all the works with the sensors there and here and there and this and that. Construction components. I think I will need the welder drone over here. Come on. You bugger. Ooh. Hello, buddy. But I'm looking into the wrong direction. I would burn out myself on the game if and would get frustrated if I would constantly try to get that to run and it doesn't work and all that stuff. So I'm not sure how I would work with it. I think I need more space so I can bring the welder drone in front of that thing completely. I will have to make some tests with the sensors, definitely. In my single player world here, the good thing, or the thing of an automatic drill, is that in this single player world, I'm playing alone, and one thing to do is to grab materials for iron and for everything like, don't know, cobalt and I have a lot of that, so I don't kind of need to fear. I don't have steel plates anymore. Okay, then. So I don't need to fear that at one point I could run out of that. But this ice thing really bothers me, because ice runs out fast. And if I don't get the system with the hydroponics, where the plants do it and you just have to keep it pressurized and have to tend to the plants, then I will have to go out there and dig up ice, and a lot of it. I dug out, I think, 150,000 units of ice, and I'm down to half, and it's not like I did spend hours and hours and hours in the game. So an automatic ice miner at one point would be, I think, neat, but question still is, can I wrap my head around that? I will need some more gyros back there. And I think I can remove the... I think I can remove two of the containers. Or should I invest all the material and get one of these monstrous big containers from Azimuth in there? I could do that. I could do that. I think I will do that. Remove all the containers. I should weld. Let me do something here. Just to be sure that this does not fly away. If I remove the cargo containers in there, I'm not sure if they are not held up, so these slopes here don't hold together. If I remove the cargo containers in there, the thrusters on the sides will just go away. I have two reactors in there, and they produce, I think, 100 kilowatts or 1 megawatt. I have to take a look at that, because the oxygen generator takes 330. Oh, that could be... Okay, do I have other materials in there? That's a thing I should take a look at. Some nickel. Can I transport that over? I can. Oh, there's more in there. I didn't clear that out. Small cargo container. Okay, let me clear that thing out.